Good morning. Why does God give written revelation? We're following through chronologically in Jeremiah, so our reading today takes us over to chapter 36, verses 1 to 4. Now it came to pass in the fourth year of Jehoiakim, the son of Josiah, king of Judah, that this word came to Jeremiah from the Lord, saying, Take a scroll of a book and write on it all the words that I have spoken to you against Israel, against Judah, and against all the nations from the day I spoke to you, from the days of Josiah even to this day. It may be that the house of Judah will hear all the adversities which I purpose to bring upon them, and that everyone may turn from his evil way, and that I may forgive their iniquity and their sin. Then Jeremiah called Baruch, the son of Neriah, and Baruch wrote on a scroll of a book at the instruction of Jeremiah all the words of the Lord which he had spoken to him. So we've noticed before that all humans are affected by the fall. The change that happened to our race when Adam and Eve sinned, and the weakness that came from that has been passed on to all of us since that time. The faculties of humanity, the feeling, ability to feel, the rational part, the will, the ability to purpose to do something and be determined to do it, all those features were disarranged at the fall. And what was easy to do before now became quite difficult many times. Many times, instead of being rational, we're driven by our feeling in the moment. We want to do this, you know, right now. And so humanity became a very difficult proposition in this messed up fallen humanity that we've all managed to be born into. So suddenly it's much easier for the lower passions to rule over us. A lot of times we hear an idea and we just reject it immediately. The first thought that comes to our mind is, no, I don't like that, and we reject it. It's not that we process it rationally or logically. We just reject it. And so it's sometimes harder to make a good decision. What we have here in our reading is God told Jeremiah, now take all the things we've talked about, and I want you to write them all out. Write them all down. We're going to preserve it in a written record. We have the benefit of having our own Bibles, and we can read them whenever we want off our phones or off our Bibles. But once we go back to it, you know, it doesn't argue back. It doesn't fight back. It just says what it said in a very dispassionate way. And so the written revelation is actually very helpful for us with fallen natures. We might be apt to make the wrong kind of decision. We can repeat it exactly what was said. We can look at it and it doesn't shout at us. It doesn't grimace at us or roll its eyes at us. It just tells us the truth. And so this is one of the means that God has to help us draw close to him. We can go over it again and we can think about it again. It makes a lot more sense sometimes when we hear it the second time. Now, another thing that we have here is God, by writing this out and preserving it through history, God's prophetic Bible writers have left us a breadcrumb trail. We can see what God did to win Israel, to win the kingdom of Judah, to win the other nations, what warnings he gave, and then what he did when they did or didn't comply with what he had to say. And so we can go back and examine this against the light of what happened before and after. So the Bible is really kind of God putting himself on record transparently out in the open. This is what happened. This is what the humans did. This is what I did. This is what I did to try to bring them back into the right place morally. So the Bible is a great and wonderful tool because it is a written revelation of God's love to us. And what we see right here is that it was for the benefit of the kingdom of Judah that he was to write this out. The lessons that came from God's dealings with the 10 northern tribes and so on, that was to help even Judah make the right decision. Let's pray. Father in heaven, thank you for your written revelation to us. Thank you that you've approached us and you give us something that we can look at more rationally sometimes, because we can read it again and your Holy Spirit can impress our hearts as we read. Help us as we read the Bible to be receptive. Help us to seek you, Lord. Help us to receive into our heart your blessings and helps. Thank you for hearing our prayers, Lord. And thank you for giving us a written revelation and putting yourself on record in the flow of history about how you dealt with people so mercifully and so carefully. Lord, we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. So this was written so that the sins of Judah they'd repent from them. Are we taking advantage of God's written revelation to us so that we'll repent of our sins? Think about that today and have a wonderful day serving the Lord Jesus Christ. God be with you.